Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women.
You know why you're here, Mary?
Yes, Matron.
Then you know what you've done?
Yes, Matron.
Full name?
Mary Elizabeth Adams.
Date of birth?
I'm not sure exactly. I haven't seen the doctor.
No, your birthday.
Oh, March the 1st, 1945.
Hairs blonde, eyes?
Green.
Height? 5'11", or thereabouts.
One pinafore, one blouse, one Bible.
Thank you, Matron.
The girls will be going to lunch soon, Mary. They'll put aside a plate. Bible class begins at 2. To take requests.
What do you like?
Be my baby.
I'm Mary.
Where's your little lamb?
I lost it.
And who's this?
Mrs. Barron.
Mrs. Who?
Barron, after the neighbour who gave her to me. I've always loved it.
By the look of you, that's not the only one.
Steady boyfriend.
Buy you all them love songs, did he?
He likes to surprise
me. You can say that again. Be my baby. My, my only baby. Gonna bend me this. Top of the it parade.
Can you sing?
Met a bloke who said I'd got what it takes. Then what I've got, each of I'm Queenie.
Are we allowed?
No.
But what about me?
You're not scared of the holy cow, are you?
She might come up.
So what if she does?
I don't want to get into trouble.
Bit late for that, duck.
Come on.
Which are the great days of a girl's life?
An hard question to answer. But you can be sure that on her greatest days, there'll be a boy in the picture somewhere.
The actual onset of labour is probably governed by the endocrine secretion of the posterior part of the pituitary gland.
First date is one of the milestones of a girl's life.
Milestones.
Ooh. Milestones. The day she stops being a child and becomes a woman. This is why the first date should be a nappy affair, but it won't if you go all... oh, Mary!
Neurotic.
Did you go neurotic?
No, I went dancing.
Dancing? Me and Alfie went dancing. Round and round the yard to the wireless.
Jonathan took me to the Palais on our first date.
Is that where you met him?
Am I the only scrubber left in laundry?
I used to sit behind him on the bus home from work. Oh, couldn't take my eyes off the back of his neck. Eventually he turned, walked me home, and we never looked back.
Saying goodnight to your date is left to your good taste and judgment, and to the way you've been brought up.
This finally overcomes the opposite influences from the progesterone and placental hormones.
Remember, as you say goodnight and thank you, that your date wants to respect you as well as like you.
And produces the rhythmic, painful contractions of labour.
Deep inside, he wants you to reject his offer of a goodnight kiss.
Painful.
Even if his actions may not support that idea.
Painful like a headache? Toothache? Earache?
I'll give you earache if you don't get working.
Hey, Norma, is there out on wind?
I've heard we're due for rain.
In your doctor's book, between you and me, I've had shocking wind.
I can't stop spending a penny.
It bears down on the bladder.
Bears down?
The uterus.
Uterus?
The womb.
You what?
what the baby's in. Look, it's upside down.
I think the head's somewhere here.
As the muscles of the uterus contract, the neck of the bag, or cervix, is drawn up and widened. Soon, this bag bursts.
Bursts?
Its contained water flows away, and the foetus...
Baby!
The foetus is expelled.
What does it mean, bursts?
Me, Alfie, are expelled from school.
It's like a great big ugly boil.
Does it make a mess?
There's all sorts comes out.
Like what?
Like pus and blood.
There's nothing blood. In here on blood.
I faint at the sight.
All right, there's bound to be a bit.
There's no mention in the book. Oh, but there won't be much. Queen, I can't do it if there's much.
Get to work.
My friend cut his
What
finger.
Friend's this then, Norma? Boyfriend, is it?
Oh, come on, Norma. Mary's only been here 2 minutes and we know about Johnny from his shoe size up.
She don't Jonathan. Talk about it.
Well, it's about time she did. What kind of friend?
Not your kind.
Perfect gentleman, was he?
Yes.
Of course he was. That's why you're in here.
Suppose it's bound to, when you think it.
What?
Start bleeding. When they cut your tummy for the baby.
They don't cut you, do they?
Not where she thinks.
Well, Alice is supposed to come out.
Come here, Dolores. This is the baby, upside down.
Like in the picture.
They don't cut you. I think it sort of drops out.
Where from?
Same way it went in.
A baby comes out there!
You've heard of that cabble through the eye of a needle?
A whole baby!
It stretches, I think. Like putting on a sweater.
So they don't cut you off?
No.
Isn't that a relief?
For the last time, am I the only scrubber left in laundry?
Queen?
What?
Give us a ciggy.
Gear up your own end.
You promise.
You're not allowed.
Why not?
It kills your brain cells.
Does it?
And seeing as you've only got one.
I'll have an accident.
You are a bloody accident.
Smashing. Isn't it?
What's that doll?
A slot.
In here.
Up the duff. Queenie's on the warpath.
I'm coming.
There's a pile of sheets this side.
Where are we exactly?
In your bedroom.
I mean, what's the address?
I don't know.
Does Queenie?
Are you writing your fella?
No.
You're writing your fella! What are you putting?
It's personal.
Dear Johnny.
Jonathan.
I really, 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 really love you.
Doll, I just need a minute. Do you mind?
No.
What?
I wish I could write to Alfie.
You can.
I can't. Got no paper.
There.
I don't know what to put.
Of course you do.
I don't. I'm not clever like you.
How about I write what you tell me?
Will ya?
If you're quick, go on.
I feel daft.
I feel daft.
No, no, you can't put that!
Well, talk to me then. Talk to me as if I'm Alfie.
Hey up.
Dear Alfie.
Should you put Alfred with it being a letter like? Dear Alfred, how are you? I hope you are well. I am well. The girls are nice. Matron is, nice. I work in the laundry. I go to Bible class. Yesterday, read the story of the
prodigal son.
This is where the bad son comes home and the good son is upset, but the father gives him a fat calf and says God is more happy when a bad person
repents
than when a good person is just good. I share a bedroom here with Norma. She is nice. When are you coming to get me?
From Dolores.
Don't you want to put love from?
You don't like soppy talk.
Go on, put love from.
Might come a bit quicker then, eh?
Yeah, he might.
You right nice.
Doll?
Yeah?
Don't you want to add a PS?
A what?
An extra bit.
About what?
Well, you know. The situation. The baby.
Oh yeah. We got a book and saw the baby upside down.
His baby.
We're not to speak of it.
Well, you don't have to. Write it.
Come on, we'll be in a bother.
You can send it on the Sunday walk. No one needs to know. You can ask him how he feels.
What's this?
What he really wants.
A mother's meeting?
I wrote myself.
Tell it to Judge Love out.
Doll?
Yeah.
He won't come unless you send it.
You send it.
But I don't know where he lives.
By the butcher's. Next street up.
And would Barbara Cartland care to follow?
5 minutes.
I'm not asking you.
And I'm telling you, 5 minutes, please.
Love letter.
No.
Just don't ask us for a stamp.
Matron?
Mary?
I'd like a day off.
A particular day, or will anyone do?
Next Wednesday, Matron. I've got an interview.
Housekeeper required for elderly lady, Eastbourne, light domestic duties and companionship, own room, child considered.
And I'm experienced now domestically.
You've contacted the lady?
She wrote back by return of post.
And she knows of your situation?
I thought it best to tell her face to face.
Sit down, Mary.
So she can see what kind of girl I am.
You're a clever girl, Mary. 5 O-levels, I'm told.
Imagine living by the sea.
And raised for more than service.
But it takes care of everything.
Except the child.
Especially the child.
Let's assume he feeds at 4 hourly intervals, round the clock, 2, 6 and 10. Each feed will take, say, 20 minutes. In between you'll bathe him, dress him, comfort him. How will you housekeep with a baby on your hip?
My cousin's got a baby. Her house is immaculate.
What else has your cousin got?
A twin tub.
A husband?
She lives on her own. She might take to a baby in the house.
Why don't you ask her?
Now.
She won't thank you for wasting her time.
It's ringing. Hello, Mrs. Wilson. This is Mary Adams. You wrote to me regarding an interview? Yes. Well, I'm just ringing to say that I'd very much like to attend. 2 o'clock's fine, yes. I look forward to meeting you too. Except, the thing is, Mrs. Wilson, I'm having a baby. Unmarried. I see. Goodbye.
You've got a job, Mary, and a home to go back to.
I know, Matron. But the thing is, I can feel it moving. I can feel it moving, and I'm scared.
Quite natural.
I'm scared I'm going to love it.
And what kind of love is that, Mary?
What kind?
The kind of love that takes or the kind of love that gives?
Just love.
What else can you offer your child, Mary? A Christian home? Financial security? A legitimate name?
I thought Matthew for a boy and Lucy for a girl.
And Matthew or Lucy, what do they need? What does a child need, Mary?
Milk?
Milk.
Toys.
Toys.
Nappies.
And who provides the milk and toys and nappies? a father?
He said he'd marry me once he's qualified. He's going to be a doctor. I won't stand in his way. I'll stand on my own 2 feet from now on.
How?
I've got a job. I'll find a room.
Alone?
With the baby.
I've seen those rooms, Mary. Damp rooms on the wrong side of town, 3 flights up, old gas fire, washing never quite gets dry, underweight babies raised on small change and handouts and the pity of friends. Girls who try to live from day to day and end up passed from man to man.
I'd never get to that.
Leave here with your baby and you're halfway there.
Not if I went home.
To your father's house?
It's his grandchild.
Would he like to see it raised without a name?
Better than not seeing it at all.
Better for whom, Mary?
It's 3:10.
For the child?
Well, I could speak to him at work.
For you?
If he says yes, could I go home today?
But if he says no, can you ever?
He's got a right to know. What would that do to your mother?
Oh, Matron. Matron.
Later, Norma.
But I've wet myself. It won't stop.
When?
About 30 minutes ago.
Mary, fetch Norma's overnight bag.
Is she all right, Matron?
She will be. Run along. Come on, lie down, Norma.
I couldn't hold it back.
Let's take a look at you.
It's all over the floor.
We'll mop it up.
Does it mean there's something wrong?
You'll live.
Is it because of the pills?
You won't help yourself by making a fuss.
Oh, have I hurt her with the pills?
What pills?
Big black ones, 12 to a box. Oh, he never said what was in them. I've studied that book, but I can't seem to find out what they were.
When?
The family deliveries to a pharmacist. He went inside, had a word with the chemist. He left the box inside my desk, where he put all his little notes in the beginning, and his letters, and a white rose, and the money to come here.
You haven't harmed the baby.
But I took the pills, though, and then when they didn't work...
What?
Oh, Matron, I swore not to tell, but I should, shouldn't I?
If you've harmed yourself, yes.
He took me to a woman. She lived above a shop. She laid me down, brought a syringe...
What was in the syringe, Norma?
I can't remember. It began with a C.
Carbolic?
I was scared to do it, but more scared not to. He held my hand like he was holding me down.
What kind of a man was he?
Married.
Why's
a
selfie? You
want to
see me
walk
the
room? So he follows me up and I show him what I got.
What's that then, doll?
A set of knives and forks off the market, a yellow vase from my auntie died, and a lovely blue bedspread, what my mum made. We'll be cosy under there, says Al. Cheeky bogger, says I. When my mum got back, I told what he says, and she says he wants to name the day.
And did he?
10th of Julember, isn't it, doll?
I says, I don't want a big one, mum. It won't cost you that. That's just as well, she says. I says, how's about what our Brenda got wedding? But it turns out she died of red for 21st. So, my mum says, looks like I'll be getting out my needle and thread.
Combine it with a christening, doll. 2 for the price of 1.
Do I have to have it christened?
Goes to the devil if you don't.
Won't the lady who has it have it christened?
I suppose she will.
Matron says she's given it a name.
I'm naming mine.
I'd have Cliff for a boy and Scylla for a girl.
You can't call a kid Scylla.
She did.
Who?
Mrs. Black.
That's short for Priscilla.
Like Queenie.
No, duck. That's long for Queen.
What do you think Norma's call hers? Do you reckon Othello were there?
She won't see him for dust.
He was here every Friday.
In her head.
Parked down the lane with the lights out.
You've kept this to yourself.
She told me not to stay out, but it don't matter, does it? Now she's gone.
Did he come in?
He just said they're looking. She looked back. Never said out. Then one night, he weren't there. First she says he had an accident. Next she thinks he's told his wife.
He's married?
But she never stopped waiting at that window.
Little madam.
They're coming to me wedding, because no one will know him.
It's always the quiet ones, isn't it?
She's going to be my bridesmaid.
Norma.
What's wrong with that?
She's a bad girl, doll. Fallen woman. Slut.
In your language.
Means something good where I come from. Means you can have a laugh. Pick up a lad and drop him when it suits. Means you can take care of yourself.
Really? So how come you've ended up in here?
You know what, Dolores? I'd like to know why this knight in shining bloody armour's not made an honest woman of you.
I am honest.
You could have wed once you'd fell. Set yourself up in your mum's back room. I mean, you've got the bloody bedspread.
He wants to have his own house.
But not your own kid.
Doll.
Because we're going to the chapel and we're gonna get married.
You're no more going to chapel than going to moon.
Leave her.
You've not even got a lad, have you?
Of course I have.
Then where is he?
At home.
He had his way, then he were on his way.
He did never.
Then who gave you that? Father Christmas?
The lad from packing.
Doll?
Yeah? What lad from packing? Alfie were meeting us from work, but he were late and it were dark. Then out comes this lad from packing. I were chilly, so he took us for a drink. Cherry brandy. Smashing. Walked me home across the wreck. He started. I said stop. I liked him. Well, they were over quick enough.
Does Alfie know?
When I got in, he'd been out looking. Said he'd fetch a policeman, but me mam said I'd be in a bother. She said to go home and say no more about it. So he did.
And have you seen him since?
I've been in here, aye?
We should tell Matron.
Forget it.
But it's
over and done with.
So the lad from packing gets away with it?
She took the drink. She let him walk her home. I dare say she were curious.
Curious? I'd say
what?
She was treated like dirt.
And you were snow bleeding white.
We'd been together 2 years. We were going to get married.
Listen, love. We all come here with that dirt on our hands. Not even them little white gloves of yours can hide it. Fucking hell.
At least I'm not wearing mine like war paint.
You can't come like Norma's lad. He's got no car, but he'll just be waiting. Won't he?
Of course he will.
Good news, Norma. Welfare services have located a family in Coventry.
Coventry? Is that near here?
Professional people. The husband's an accountant.
Will he be there first?
They have a little girl, aged 3.
Someone to play with?
A lifetime companion.
What if he doesn't fit in?
He's just the same colouring. Blue eyes like the girl.
Blue eyes?
He'll be part of their family, Norma. Raised as their own.
An accountant, you say, with figures.
And a thriving practice.
What if he takes after me? I'm hopeless at maths.
They're very grateful to you, Norma. A healthy baby boy.
He's healthy?
Perfectly.
Are you sure?
Norma, you've had plenty of time to put this out of your mind.
I've tried, Matron.
It's time to look forward.
I will. I am.
I hope we've helped you, Norma.
I'm grateful for everything you've done.
Is anyone meeting you tomorrow?
Tomorrow, Matron?
Will anyone go with you?
What exactly am I doing tomorrow?
Signing the papers.
And then I'll get to see him.
You'll get to go home.
Can't go home, Matron. He won't know where I am.
Who won't?
Coventry.
Has the procedure not been explained to you, Norma?
Procedure?
Sit down. Welfare services will take your baby and place him with his new family in Coventry. In due course, the magistrate's court will pass what is called a consent to adoption order. This makes your baby the legitimate child of the adopted parents. Their name will replace yours on the certificate of birth.
What is their name?
This means you have no legal right to contact your child.
Until he's settled in.
Sorry, Norma. You have no right to contact your child.
Well, what if we get married?
I hope you will get married, but not to somebody else's husband. The tablets drop your milk, Norma.
Yes, Matron.
Don't let the other girls see you like this.
I won't.
We wouldn't want to worry them.
I have done wrong.
Perhaps we'll bring you back here tomorrow. A few days in the sick room might give you a rest.
I'm going to hell, aren't I?
Who on earth told you that?
I am, I know I am.
No,
blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Be my baby.
You never said you had pipes.
I haven't.
They sound all right to me.
I couldn't even make this quiet. Queen!
Bleeding out. Doll, I thought you were the only cow.
Them stairs are pitch black.
What's she doing?
You've been stopping in the sick room, ain't you, Norma? She woke me up. Scared me half to death.
What's wrong, Norma?
She was going through me back. I says, Norma, what, you lost? But she pulls me covers off. I says, Norma, get to bed. But she's opening me drawers. I says, Norma, what are you doing? She says, he's here. I know he's here. So we thought we'd look in your room.
Have you got him?
Who?
Have they put him in with you?
Tie down. Norma. Come here. Come here, Norma.
They drug him, you see. They drug him so quick.
Who, Norma?
Blue Eye.
When?
I was in the light room. They were shouting. Lie flat. Lift your legs. Bend your knees. Pull up. Bed out. Down. And there he was. A boy, they said. And they took him.
Didn't you hold him?
I'm going to hear him cry.
They must have let her hold him.
They put him with the others. There were lots of them crying. But I knew when it was him.
You didn't even see him?
I know why.
Why?
Because I can't make a nappy.
She's been on the ale.
They wouldn't show me how. I kept asking, but they wouldn't show me how.
You won't need to, Norma. The thing is...
Listen.
What?
He's crying. Can't you hear him? He's
right.
Crying.
Dull.
Yeah?
On your back, love.
You what?
On your back.
What are you doing?
Legs in air. Oh. Peg on nose. Clean the mucky bum. Slap a bit of cream on so it don't get sore.
You tickling.
Open legs. Wider, please. You know you can. Fold once, twice. Pin through nappy, not leg of baby. Fold once and twice and pin again. Lift baby up. Dip dummy in gin. Stick in gum.
On your feet.
Dolores, take Norma back.
Can I stay with her?
It's past your bedtime.
But Matron, she's upset.
For tonight.
Thank you, Matron.
And tonight only.
Yes, Matron.
To the sick room.
Why can't she see him? Why can't she hold him?
Why don't you take your hands off what's mine?
Get to bed.
You're not having it, do you hear me? It's mine.
We'll discuss this in the morning.
I won't be here in the morning.
Where are you going?
She can't keep me here. No one can.
Then where will you go? Home?
No.
Then where will you go?
What will you do?
How will you live?
I'll find a way.
You're 19 and alone, Mary. There is no other way.
Are you a mother matron?
Are you?
I know how it feels.
But have you got what it needs?
I have everything. In here.
Believe me, child, it's not enough.
What would you know of love?
More than you'd learn from any record.
I pity you, Matron. You'll never understand.
If you say so. Oh. You're acting like a kid.
I'm growing up fast.
There's no buses at this time of night.
I'll walk.
All the way home.
Aren't you listening? I'm not going home.
You're 9 months gone. Where else can you go?
Eastbourne.
You'll get no further than the end up lane.
Are you trying to stop me?
I'm telling you, kid. It's a dead end.
I'll get through.
And how will you get out house? She locks every door at night.
I'll break a window and run. Now will you stop asking me questions and help me pack up my singles?
You're not taking them.
Of course I am.
Oh! leave it here. Locked. Holy bloody cow.
Try the window.
We're in tactic.
There's an iron drain pipe.
In your condition.
She can't do this.
She can do what she wants.
And so can we.
Who told you that?
First thing in the morning. We're out.
Of course we are.
Queen.
What?
Get it.
Oh, move over, fatty.
We were glad it chamber popped.
And you tied it off?
I've done my best.
No!
Mary, this is serious.
She's all right.
There's too much at stake.
She's all right with me.
She could bleed to death. Is that what you want?
Where she goes, I go.
She's right, you know. The longer you hold her, the harder it'll be.
Harder to what?
To let her go.
I thought you were on my side.
I am.
We're running away.
Face it, love. We're going nowhere.
We can, now she's born.
Don't you think? If there were any other way, I'd have found it. I'd have Billy with me now. Every day I tell myself I'll go and get him back.
There's no one to stop you.
And there's nowhere to go.
So you're telling me that I never had a choice?
Come on.
Will I know her, do you think? If I see her in the street?
It's time.
Her name's Lucy.
I am right, aren't I? I'll run her a bath.
I'll call the doctor.
What will you tell him?
That's not your concern. You did well.
Did I? Maybe I've been good for some after all.
See to your friend.
Mary, do you think Norma's feeling better?
I'm sure she is.
Will you go and visit her?
I don't know where she lives.
You best write me her address so I can ask her to the wedding.
How about you give me yours?
Will you send us a letter?
If you like.
You'll never get a letter.
All right. You forgot your gloves.
They're in the case.
She'll want you in your gloves.
I'd like to introduce you.
Norma.
To break the ice, but when you come to stay.
Doll, we're wanted in kitchen.
I don't mind you going now you're doing me a letter.
Good.
Can I do you one back?
If you like.
I'll start tonight.
Queenie, I've got work to do.
My address.
Holly Park. Sounds posh.
You will come.
That'd get the nets twitching.
I need you to come.
Won't I give the game away?
You're the only one I can talk to.
It's best forgot. All of it.
How?
You'll find a way.
I don't blame you for saying what you said. Not after Billy. Who's Billy?
Your son. Her. I kept her warm till morning. Lucy, my baby.
Thank you.
would just like to say a few very, very quick thank yous to four very important people. First of all, our director, Catherine Livesey. Thank you for everything you've done. Our lighting and sound technician, Dr. Gill Bates. Costume mistress, Miss Lisa Armstrong. And our assistant light and sound technician, Edward Panek.
And the cast would really like to just say a massive thank you to Sarah, who's put so much time into making this possible and helping out. She's been so enthusiastic. So thank you very much.
Just the very last thing that we wanted to say was we have been so moved through this whole project that all the profit that we've made from ticket sales, if there is any, we're going to donate to a mother and baby home in Yorkshire just as soon as we can find one. And just because we've been so moved by this whole experience. So thank you very much for coming tonight.